Hi everyone, this is Dr. Chukka Shantaya, Associate Professor of Computer Science and Engineering Department in Institute of Aeronautical Engineering College, Hyderabad. Today we discuss about the machine learning concept, that is about the concept learning. We are discussing a specific algorithm, that is about the find S algorithm. That find S algorithm is part of a concept learning, right? Yes, F stands for the specific, means we can start the specific algorithm, specific hypothesis. We are compare, we are discuss about the what is the meaning of general hypothesis as well as what is the meaning of specific hypothesis. Why? Because we are mainly discuss about the finding specific hypothesis in this concept learning algorithms. So for that purpose we discuss about the basic concept, the what is general hypothesis and what is specific hypothesis. Here the name indicates general to specific ordering of hypothesis. The name indicates general, means general one. We are, as well as specific, means specific. For example, takes about general, I will give some clarification about the what is the difference between the general as well as what is the difference between the specific by some general example. For example, your friend go to the outside for the lunch. You say to your friend, yes, please bring the rice for afternoon lunch. Here rice is general, means general. From that, your friend may be bring the rice, anyone. Either maybe food, fast food, or maybe general rice or white rice like that. But you mention the rice, means it is about the vegetarian rice or maybe non-vegetarian. Means here go to the vegetarian. You mention specific vegetarian or non-vegetarian. We are mentioning specific. Means rice is here, food is a specific, for example. Non-veg as well as veg is specific. Like that, one more example about the, some clear clarification about the specific as well as general. Bird. Bird is a general. Means from the general, we are mentioning the specific, means about the dove. Means it is specific. Bird is a general as well as dove is a specific. Means that is some more general differences, general meaning about the bird as well as general as well as specific. According to the concept learning, what is the meaning of general hypothesis, what is the meaning of the specific hypothesis? Many learning algorithms for the concept learning organize search through the hypothesis based by the relying on a very useful structure that exists may offer any concept learning problem. Means, in the especially machine learning concept algorithms, we discuss various hypotheses. Means, number of hypotheses we discuss. What is the need of the hypothesis means? Mainly it is need of the hypothesis is nothing but we try to propose a solution or try to propose a solve any complex problem. From that complex problems, we select the best hypothesis from the large number of hypotheses. In general, specific ordering of the hypothesis, by taking advantage of this naturally occurring structure over the hypothesis space, we can design learning algorithms that exhaustively search even infinite hypothesis space without implicitly emulating the every hypothesis. Means, we have number of hypotheses are there. From that number of hypotheses, we are select the best one. as well as we are select the one means number of large space means number of is there, means number of hypotheses are there. From that we are select the best one, or from that we are try to select the best one. So we discuss about the what is different between the general as well as specific based on the our example. Here H1 hypothesis contains the strong question mark, strong question mark means H1 has a nearly 6 parameters are there. H1 hypothesis only has the 6 parameters. From that we take sunny as well as strong, means these two conditions, these two parameters are satisfied by the target function, that is about the enjoy the water sport, means enjoy the water sport or not, means enjoy the sport or not, means we are mainly focused on these two, sunny as well as strong. Each is conditioned to, it is satisfied the two parameters, either may be sunny as well as either may be strong. Yes, based on these two conditions, he may be enjoy the water sport. Whereas come the second one, second hypothesis, means sunny, question mark, means here 6 parameters, means hypothesis 2 is also the 6 parameters. But whereas come to the hypothesis 1, they are satisfied with the 2 parameters, that is about the sunny as well as strong. But whereas come to the hypothesis 2, it is satisfied with only sunny, remaining is all question marks, means here question marks indicates the general, means there is any value it may be accepted, general one. Means in this first hypothesis we are satisfied with two conditions, there is about the two parameters, the sunny as well as strong, then is enjoy the water sport, okay, enjoy the sports. So likewise come to the second one, this only sunny, only one parameter is satisfied, only one parameters, means remaining these all comes under the question mark, means about the question mark, means it is about the any parameters, means any parameters accepted, that is thing about. As well as how we can represent the general as well as general hypothesis as well as specific hypothesis in concept learning. In this general hypothesis we are discuss how it is specified, how it is represented, as well as concept, as well as specific hypothesis, how can represent it. Generally, we discuss here, we are represent the some specific hypothesis, means we are treated as S, for example. It is represented with null value, means pi. Null value or pi value means whenever any attribute value, means about any parameters contains the null value, it must be of specific. Whereas come to the general representation, means general, it is, for example, we can represent as G. It is represented by the question mark, means any parameter value is accepted in the training examples. Specific means it is compulsory null value. It is represented by the hypothesis specific is in the form of the null value, means about the pi. Whereas come to the general one, means about the, yes, it is represented by the question mark. These attributes values are, these parameters are depends about the number, how many attributes are there in the training example. For example, the training example has the 4 parameters, for example, 4. You can represent the in specific, we can represent the 4 training examples or 4 attributes. How can represent by specific? Means we are mentioning the pi value, means 1, 2, 3, 4. Why? Because its attributes value is parameters, 4 parameters. So we can represent specific as a 4 null values. Again, general also. Here you can represent the general is question mark 1, 2, 3, 4. Means here 4 attributes, means number of attributes values is number of attributes is depends on the number of parameters are there, number of count, number of attributes are there. Based on that, we can represent the general is number of, this number is depends on the attribute values. That is about the representation of the general as well as specific in the concept learning. Right. How we can come to the our example. That is about the hypothesis 1 as well as hypothesis 2. From these two hypotheses, which one is general as well as which one is specific? When you observe this hypothesis 1 as well as hypothesis 2, hypothesis 1 is contains the two specific values, means two specific conditions, specific parameters. That is about the sunny as well as strong. It is about the H1, means hypothesis 1 is contains the two parameters. Whereas come to the H2, it is only to satisfy the sunny conditions, sunny parameters. Remaining all under the question mark, means about the general. So, means whenever how many number of conditions or number of parameters satisfied, more number of parameters are satisfied in hypothesis, any hypothesis, it becomes a specific. As well as whenever, even which hypothesis is less number of parameters are satisfied or less number of the constraint is satisfied or it comes to more general parameters or more general constraints, it is comes under the general one. When compared with these two, means H1 is contained the two parameters, two conditions, decided the two constraints when compared with the H1. So automatically we can say that H2 is more general than the H1. Why? Because in H1 is satisfy the two conditions or two parameters. Whereas come to the H2, only one parameter is satisfy the constraint. Means only one constraint is there. So like that. And one more hint about the, 1 minute notice about the general one as well as specific one about the general hypothesis as well as specific hypothesis. We can simply remember based on my analysis. Means, for example, we can also identify if number of parameters are specific, it is specific. And if number of parameters are general, means about select question mark, it is called general hypothesis. That is simple notice about my observation. Means first one is number of parameters are satisfied, means number of parameters, means about the first hypothesis H1, hypothesis sunny, as well as HD is strong. And whereas come to the second hypothesis, only H1 is the, means only sunny is parameter is the, it is satisfied. Only one parameter is satisfied. So automatically it is called general one. H2 is general one, general hypothesis, and H1 is specific hypothesis. That is about one more observation about in my understanding about the concept learning. General hypothesis as well as specific hypothesis. Yes. We can define more general than or equal to the relation. Relation in terms of the set of hypothesis. In set of instances that satisfy the two hypotheses. Yes, we can discuss general. Given hypothesis H of Hj as well as Hk. Means two hypotheses. Here H of J is one hypothesis. As well as H of K is a second hypothesis. Means whereas Hj is the more general or equal to the Hk. Means Hj is general, more general or equal to the Hk. Means if and only if any instant that satisfies the Hk is also satisfies the H1. Right now, Hj. Means if and Hj is more general, means Hj is more general than or equal to the Hk. So, if and only if any instant that satisfies the Hk is also satisfied the Hi. We can take say previous example about the H. For example, Hj is a hypothesis 1. First one is sunny. Second one is question mark. Second one is question mark. As well as one is strong. next question mark. As well as, for example, HK, that statement justification. It is satisfied the first parameter, that was only. Next is question mark. Means general. Right. We can discuss the, I can try to give the some general meaning about the HK as well as J as well as K. Means HJ is more general. HJ is more than general than equal to the HK. Means about this one. If and only if any instant that satisfies the HK is also satisfied the HC. Means the HK is satisfied the Sunny parameters. This is about this parameter. As well as H2 is also HK. HJ is also satisfied the Sunny parameters. If any instant that satisfies the HK is also satisfied in HI. Means HC. That is thing about the this. Means sometimes find the inverse full. Useful and will say that HC is more specific than HK when HK is more than greater than the HC. Means that is thing about it. Next come to the our main concept, Findus algorithm. The Findus, finding a maximum specific hypothesis. That is thing about the our main concept. Findus means finding a maximally specific hypothesis from the various hypotheses. What is algorithm about this Findus algorithm and how we can discuss this one? First one is initialize the H to the most specific hypothesis in H1. Is in H, capital H. For each positive training instance X, for each attribute constraints A in H. If constraint A is satisfied X, means it is positive, then do nothing. And else, replace A in H by the next more general constraints that is specified by the X. Next, we discuss about output the hypothesis X. Means, the first one is we have generalized, we can discuss about the first one. Initialize the most specific hypothesis in H. Means, H is defined most specific. That is about the specific is represented by the pi or maybe null symbol. Like that. First, we can initialize. As well as general, we also discuss here H1 means about the hypothesis. It is a specific hypothesis. Means a hypothesis specific. It is initialized maximum specific. And general means about the general one. We can discuss about this one. Is about general means question mark. Means general. So, we discuss one by one with example. First, what is the basic constraints or the basic principles are there in finding a S algorithm? Find S algorithm. The find S algorithm basic concept learning in machine learning algorithm. It is a find S algorithm is a basic concept learning in machine learning. The algorithm considers only positive examples. It finds the most specific hypothesis that first all positive examples only. And the Findus algorithm starts with the most specific hypothesis and generalizes this hypothesis each time it fails to classify any observed positive examples. And the Findus algorithm moves from the most specific hypothesis to the most generalized hypothesis. The first basic principle is about the Findus algorithm is what the conditions are there in this finding. S algorithm. Conditions are there. For the first and foremost condition about the Findus algorithm is it considers only positive examples. Positive hypothesis. Means it is mainly focused on constraints, only condition. Means you can solve any, we can perform the algorithm, or start some algorithm. It is mainly focused on positive algorithms. And the second condition is it ignores it ignores negative examples. Means negative hypothesis. Means second condition. Means our first condition is it is only consider the positive examples. Means positive hypothesis. And second condition is it is not consider negative examples. Means negative hypothesis. And then we are starts one more condition about the we can find the specific hypothesis from this general hypothesis to the specific hypothesis. Remember this thing especially when you solve the problem, we can solve any problem by using specific condition or specific algorithm. Means one more notes about conditions about the some conditions about the Finder's algorithm. If any parameter or any attribute value or any parameter is compared with null value, it becomes same value, means it becomes the attribute value. Means for example, we can compare the null value with Sunny. Means null value with Sunny. For example, means if any parameter is compared with null value, it comes parameter as output. For example, we can compare with null with Sunny. That is comparison about the output is about the Sunny. That is about the condition. Means one more condition about the Finder's algorithm. Means if any parameter is compared with the null value, a output is parameter, means about the parameter value. And then if any parameter is compared with general, that is about the not specific, it comes about the general value, general parameter. Means for example, we can compare with the general value against Sunny. It is comes under the general, means about the question mark. That is about the one more condition in Finder's algorithm. And one more condition is there, means if any two different parameters are compared, if any two parameters are compared, two different parameters are compared, it is also comes under the general one. Means for example, we can compare the Sunny with Rainy. That output is question mark, means general one. As well as we can compare with the same two parameters, that is about the Sunny against Sunny. For example, two parameters same, so it is comes under the same parameter as the output. These are the four parameters especially we can solve the, we can find the S algorithm, we can start some S algorithm, Finder's algorithm. These are the basic conditions are there when you solve the training examples. I can try to find the sum, the specific hypothesis from the training examples. The first one is, if any parameter is compared with the specific, the parameter is become as output. And the second one is, if any parameter is compared with the general, that's a question mark, the output is question mark, means about the general output. And if any two different parameters are compared, it is become as a general, means about the question mark. And if any two similar parameters are compared, it come out the same output. Remember this, keep in mind to solve the Finder's algorithm. Why? Because the entire algorithm depends on these conditions. Right. We can take example. Our algorithm start with the most specific hypothesis, means we can initialize the hypothesis, most hypothesis. Why? Because most specific hypothesis. Why? Because we are mainly concentrated on specific hypothesis. So that specific hypothesis defined about the this, means about this question mark, about the this one null value, hypothesis value is null as well as null. Means here six attribute values are there, six are there. What it indicates? Means we are in our example, we have six attributes. So we are mentioning these six as a hypersonal values. Means these six count is, means here 1, 2, 3, 4 as well as 5 and 6. Nearly six parameters are there. Means that number is depends on the attribute values or parameters about the in our training example. Here come to the our example. Means here six attributes are there. First one is sky, temperature, humidity, wind, water as well as forecast. Each one is finally target output, means target parameter. Means it is not considered about the our example. Means sky 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as well as 6. So we take 6 parameters as a specific one from this specific algorithm. So take the next example, and if it is negative, then just ignore the hypothesis. Means it cannot change the hypothesis. Means in our training examples, it is a negative result. Means about the negative means here no. Means no indicates negative result. You can simply don't compare with or don't take a consideration in the specific finders algorithm. Why? Because the finders algorithm will mainly consider only positive, means only yes result values, means yes. Okay, simply ignore about this one, means about the negative, means no indicates reference negative. So like that, right, ma'am? If the example is positive and if the initial hypothesis is too specific, then update the current hypothesis to the general condition. Means if the example is positive, this one, means for example, first hypothesis means first day hypothesis is yes, means it is about the positive, means it represents the yes, no represents the negative. So first example is positive, then too specific as well as too specific, then update the current hypothesis to the general condition about this one, and repeat the step 2 and step 3, means for all the training examples. We about this training all examples, all training examples. This one means the first one is take the example, means take the next example, if it is negative, then don't change the hypothesis. Means it is a negative, for example, there is no any changes in that hypothesis. In case if the current example is positive, then we can hypothesis too specific, then update the hypothesis to the general condition. Repeat the steps 2 and step 3 for all training examples. And after completing all training examples, we have final hypothesis which can be used to class with the new examples. Right. We discuss one by one. According to our enjoy the sports game is example in our concept learning. We take 6 attribute values and we take here 4 days are there. From that, the enjoy the sports is our target function. Here 6 attributes are there. About the sky, air temperature, humidity, wind, water, forecast, and finally target function is enjoy the sport, means yes or no. This enjoy the sport is depends on the parameter values. That is about the sunny, warm, normal, strong, warm, same. Means it is satisfied all conditions. Based on these conditions, attribute values, S is enjoy the water sport. Means it is enjoy the sports. Becomes a S. Means automatically the first example is positive. Next, second one. Second parameters, attribute values. Means sunny sky is a sunny. At air temperature warm. Humidity is high. Wind is strong. Water is warm. As well forecast is same. Here also, yes, it is also enjoy the sports. Means it is also become as a positive hypothesis or maybe positive example. And second, third one is a third day. Means sunny, sky value, attribute value is rainy. Air temperature is cold. Humidity is high. And wind is strong. Water is warm. As well as forecast change. So it is not satisfied. It is means enjoy sports means no. So it becomes a negative hypothesis or maybe negative example. Next, fourth day. Means sky is sunny, air temperature is warm, humidity is high, and wind is strong, water is cool, and forecast is change. So it is also enjoy the sports. Means yes, means it's about the, it is also four. Means positive. Means based on this example, here nearly four positive means three positive examples are three positive hypothesis there, means positive hypothesis. Based on this example, only one negative hypothesis there. means whereas S indicates positive means 1, 2, 3. So, 3 positive hypothesis. And negative means no indicates negative. So, 1 negative hypothesis. We discuss step by step as well as we take one by example one by one, then we discuss. The first we consider means first we consider the hypothesis to more specific hypothesis. That's about the H1. H0 means more specific hypothesis. Means first take most, you can only slice the first hypothesis, most specific hypothesis. That is about the we can take. Hypothesis 1 means here take some examines about the hypothesis 0. First we can slice the hypothesis most specific. Next one is consider example 1 means about the example 1 is here. Right. This example has a positive outcome. Means this example is positive outcome. So The data in example 1 is sunny. Means about the data is, example 1 is sunny. Means about this example is, about this data is, data values is sunny, warm, normal, strong, warm as well as same. Means these 6 parameters are. Means the data is in example is sunny, warm, normal, strong, warm as well as same. So our initial hypothesis is more specific. So and we have to generalize this, generalize it for this example. Hence, hypothesis become as a once. Means, the H1 is about the initial hypothesis more specific. We try to generalize it with first input values. Means, first example values. That is about the first value. Means, here, six values are the based on our input value. Input, our example. H means pi, as well as pi, as well as not pi, or pi, 6. And 6 values are there from the first example about the sunny, warm, normal, strong, warm as well as same. So we can compare this means H1, H0 is actually here H initial value for example pi means null value. So, we can take 6 values about the first example. That is about the sunny is represented as S based on our understanding prisma. Next, warm. It is represented as a W. And next one is normal. It is represented as a N. And it is strong. Means it is represented as S. As well as it is warm. Means about the warm. Means W. Again W. And next one is same. So, we can take this comparison first. Means this one is example 1 about the this one is hypothesis, this one is input. For example, input parameters will be input examples. So we can compare this one, we can compare these two, most specific hypothesis as well as our example. Means pi with S means it is about the yes. Why? Because initially I can say if any parameter is compared with the null value, there is a pi symbol or specific value, it becomes a parameter as an output. Means here pi with S is S as well as pi means null value with means pi with W is equal W as well as W with N is equal to N and W with S is equal to S as well as W with pi is equal to W and W with pi with S is equal to pi. Means it becomes a H1. You can observe this one. Same output. Why? Because null values are there. So warm, S stands for the warm, sunny, S stands for the sunny, W stands for the warm, N stands for the normal, S stands for the strong, W stands for the warm, as well as S stands for the same. That is about the H1 hypothesis. It becomes a H1. Right. Again, second example is H1 is a same example. Why? Because same output. Why? Because null, we can compare the specific one. So we can come as a same as this. In previous example 1, we take some hypothesis, specific hypothesis by null values and we can add the example 1 and we can get the hypothesis 1. This hypothesis 1 parameters is sunny, warm, normal, strong, warm and same. Then we can move to the second example. That is about the considered example 2. Before we can start the Bindes algorithm, there is a specific or not means that example is contains the positive value or positive, it supports the positive or not. So, the second one is, you have some parameters, sunny, warm, high, strong, warm, same, and target function is yes, means it supports the positive value. So find a cell algorithm focused on positive. So then we can take what are the input values are there in the second example. That is about the sunny, warm, high, strong, warm, same. Six parameters are there. Then we can compare with hypothesis 1 to the hypothesis 2. In this hypothesis 2, first we take some hypothesis as input. Take hypothesis 1 is a specific general one. Then we can add a second example. That is about the warm, sunny, warm, high, strong, warm, as well as same. So we can compare with this input value, second input with first hypothesis. That is about the here. First hypothesis H1 is sunny, warm, normal, strong, warm, same. Six is there. Six attributes are there. Six parameters are there. Six. So we can take second input. That is about the second input is sunny, warm, high, strong, warm, same. Then we can compare with this. Means this one is H1, this one is H1 hypothesis. We can take some input from the second example. That is about the way because it has some positive. So it takes output. Then we can compare with yes, we have to compare with yes. W with compare with W is W. It is normal. Here is warm. So, sorry. Here is high. Yes. Here is normal. In a hypothesis one. Whereas come to this one. S means about the here. Is high. So, when compared with different parameters, it is a general one. It's about the question mark. Next, second one is strong with strong is strong. Warm is with warm is good, warm, and same with same. So this is about the become as a H2. Means H2 is defined, H2 is generated. That is about the S, comma, W, comma, question mark, comma, W, comma, W, S, comma, W, comma, S. Six parameters. Means strong, warm, question mark, then strong, warm, and same. You can check it. Means H stands for the sunny, W stands for the warm, question mark, as well as H stands for the strong, and W stands for the warm, as well as space. Means it becomes as H2. It means H2, hypothesis 2. That is the thing about that. Means second, finally, we can get the output, hypothesis output is sunny, warm, question mark, strong, warm, as well as C. Right. Means here, get us some second hypothesis. Again, we can move to the next example. Before starting some next example parameters, it must be defined, must be checked. One second. Means about the input example. Right. In example 2, hypothesis 2 is taken as a hypothesis. Means here about sunny is warm, question mark, and strong, warm, same. So here takes some more the first example is completed why because it is support the positive. And the second example is completed. It is a positive. But when it comes to third example, means third example is no, means it is negative. Rainy, cold, high, strong, as well as warm and change. Means the enjoy the sports is no. Because automatic no indicates negative. So we can simply, we can strike forwardly, we can ignore about this. Why? Because find a cell algorithm supports the only positive one. Means positive examples. So actually this one is H2. This one is H2. This H2 is become as a S3. Why? Because there is no changes. Means there is no acceptance of the negative examples in the find a cell algorithm. So then we can go to the become as H3. Why? Because there is no changes. So means here H3 same value. Means here it becomes a because it is awesome negative. Example, next example is third example is negative. So you can simply ignore about that. Means it is comes at the same example is a H3. Means here H3 is called it becomes H3 is a S3. Why? Because this one is negative. So you can simply. Then we can take some input about this one. Means fourth example. Means we can take fourth example. Once again, check it. The target function value is either positive or negative. If it is positive, we can take as a consideration. If it is negative, we can simply ignore. So, here fourth example is sunny, warm, high, strong, cool, change, and yes means. So, yes indicates positive response, means positive example. So, you can take its alert values, that parameter values as an input. With this, and then we compare with means. Here is sunny, warm indicates, double indicates warm, as well as next one is high, and next one is strong, and next one is cool. Next one is change. Means we can take. Right. Means here you can, okay, once again compare. Means same parameters becomes the same. Same parameters also becomes the same. If any, means if any parameters with null, means general one is becomes as general. Here is sorry. Here is some order W. Then same parameters comes to the same parameter. As well as here is differs. This is a question mark. Here is also differs. It is a question mark. That is about the H4 means it becomes as a H4. Means H4 is finally become as, we can once again check it. Here, sunny, warm, means H4 is finally, H4 is sunny, yes, warm, question mark, strong, question mark, question mark. So, this is about the H4 means, because the fourth example is, in this example, positive outcome. The data as well present in the example is sunny, warm, high, strong, cool, change. We compare every single attribute with the initial data. If any mismatches, find the replace the particular attribute value as a question mark. Means, if any misplace, means different parameters, different values is there, we can replace with the question mark. After doing this, we can get the hypothesis, means H4. It's about the H4. Means, H4 is sunny, warm, as well as strong. These are about the final hypothesis. Means final hypothesis, this one. We compare this. Means, it is final output. Final hypothesis. Means here, we can define our output is H4 is final hypothesis. It is a sunny. One second. H4 is final hypothesis sunny, warm, question mark, strong, question mark, question mark. Yes, we can take on cross-checking about this output, this hypothesis specific about the hypothesis correct or not. You can take some input values, means same examples, and we can compare with that also. Here actually, you can go come to the free basic of the same example about the these four examples, about 4 days. About 6 attributes, we can take. Actually, here is negative value is there. About the third example is negative value. We can simply ignore over that. Then we can check it. Means we'll compare the parameters and get the what is output. Means here sunny is there. Means about the same. Means about the yes. Okay, because same parameters are same. Next, here warm is there, here warm is there, here warm is there. Again, finally warm. And here, normal is there, high is there, as well as high is there. Means it is somewhat different. Means automatically generalized one. Here, strong is there, as well as strong is there. Again, we can come to the strong. And we can take warm, as well as cool. Means it differs. Next one is same, change. Why? Because we can simply ignore. Why? Because it has some negative impact, negative values. So, point is algorithm is not support the negative. So, it is also question mark. Means same, say change. Means it is about the means. When this compare with the output H4, means H4 as well as general comparison, these two is same or not. Means yes, S is equal to yes, S double is equal to W, question mark, yes, question mark. So automatically the final fourth one is fourth item hypothesis is correct as per the our Findus algorithm. So in this especially Findus algorithm is mainly focused on the one more time I can give you some example about the, give some condition about the S4 Findus algorithm. First one is, we can first one is instead the specific hypothesis. From that, we can take input examples. In that input examples, is there any positive? In fact, positive examples are there. Positive results are there. We can compare with the specific to the, with the positive example. And we can go to the second example. Is there any second positive response? Positive example is there. Again, we can compare with the previous next one. and then third one, we can go to the next. Means before we can take some any example, first we can check it. That example is has the positive result or negative result. If it has the positive result, we can go to the further process. If it is negative result, a negative example, we can simply discard that, we can simply eliminate that our process. That is about the basic principle about the Findus algorithm. Means first we can, the parameters are same, means about the output, the example outputs, the input examples are positive, we can take as a consideration. Our example is, and the input example is negative, we can simply ignore about that. Means you can simply discard from the our process. So finally, we can get the H4 hypothesis like this one. Means when compare this, first we can take some of the producer Findus algorithm, then we can check it once again about this parameter with the general comparison about the this parameters. Same values comes, H4 is correct, as well as general comparison is correct. Automatically, H4 is the final hypothesis based on the Findus algorithm. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.